Hello to my Libras. All right, Libras, this is your May 1st reading. It'll go up a couple of days, either a couple of days or a day before. A couple of days before May 1st. We are officially in the last quarter moon phase. Last quarter moon phase is about introspection, right? So technically, the last quarter moon phase starts on May 1st, right? And so you want to start kind of sort of going back in your mind and thinking about what you may have been indecisive about and removing the rose-colored glasses. But it's more of like introspection of self, like not necessarily like, oh, this person gave me all these clues that, you know, that they weren't this and that or whatever. This is about you being coming off of that internal indecisiveness about things, right? And you all are incredibly smart sign. A lot of people think that you all are not as smart because of your ruling planet, Venus. You love nice things, right? Aesthetically pleasing things. And a lot of people don't think that you're as smart, but you all are incredibly smart, right? So let's get into it. 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 I'm going to also give you some questions that you can kind of sort of think about leading up to this last quarter moon phase. This wants to pop off. Here we have the Ten of Pentacles, so that's good to lead out with that, right? So let's get into it. Let's get into it. I've already asked Most High God for complete and total clarity in every area of your lives, Libras. So let's see what's in your cards. Page of Swords. We also have the Knight of Swords. We also have the Two of Swords, the Three of Wands, and then also the Knight of Pentacles. Okay, so Page of Swords, right? Something possibly could have something to do with an earth sign. Taurus, or their family values, right? Something having to do with money, wealth, material possessions, practicality, home life, health, generosity, right? That you're now starting to give a lot of air to, a lot of thought to. Here we have Page of Swords, Knight of Swords. We also have the Two of Swords, right? We also have the Three of Wands and then also the Knight of Pentacles. Somebody is starting to see, just like, you know, remember you all moved from your heart chakra, right? Because your air sign moving from the heart chakra. Your love language could be significantly different from other people's love language, right? So you're looking at from heart matters, right? The way you see money, the way you see family values, the way you see material possessions, generosity, health, home, practicality could be so significantly different from other people's. You would be doing yourself a disservice to keep the blindfolds on, right? Some people will literally do anything for money. And some people have to find out the hard way of what people will do for money, right? Here we have the Two of Swords here, right? So even if it's you just have your anxiety about something is going away very, very soon. Even if you have the blindfold, the rose colored glasses have been removed. Even if your head and heart are at war with another area of your life. Let's say it's two situations in your life right now where your head and heart are kind of at war with each other. One thing you're clear about is that you look for, you know, fairness and equality within yourself, right? Remember, like I said, you all are obviously Libras, and I'm talking to you if you have Libra anywhere in your birth chart. You all are looking for balance, fair-minded, justice, defenders. Sometimes you all can be indecisive and a bit adventurous, but source is saying when it comes to, you know, when it comes to family values and core values and things like that, source is saying take the blindfolds off. That'll help you ahead of time with a lot of things to make some decisions where you're not indecisive, where your head and heart are not at war with each other. So something else that's going on in your universe about two situations over here could seem totally unrelated to a situation going on over here, right? So your head and heart may be at war with this over here, but over here you may be saying, I didn't see how they were tying together at first, but now things are starting to make sense. Now things are, the rose-colored glasses have been removed. Here we also have the Three of Wands here. They don't always have to be forcibly removed, right? I feel like somebody's thinking about creating legacy, you know, with somebody, but remember, your idea of Your idea of money, wealth, material possessions, practicality, home, health, generosity could be different from your sisters. It could be different from your brothers. It can be different from your moms, your dads. Remember, even if they're the same zodiac sign, sun sign, their birth chart, I can guarantee you, is different than yours. Pull your birth chart, please, to see exactly what your values are and theirs are as well. You don't even have to leave your house. You can just think about the people you were raised around. Start right there first, right? So that your head and heart don't have to be at war with each other and whoever you choose to build a legacy with. Again, it's not always forcibly removed. I feel like once you get to a point of just always having somebody have to cut you deep with your word, with their words and their actions for you to say, oh my God, okay, now it makes sense. It shouldn't have to make sense there. This is where, again, as an air sign, you're incredibly smart. The element of air connects us with action, intelligence, ideas, logic, communication, thought, truth, right? Mercury was just retrograde up until April 25th. What is your truth about the situation with your logical mind? You don't need to gather everybody together and have a powwow, a conversation about something. Sources say, you know, you're financially independent, looking at the cards here. Some people don't have the same values as you have, right? And so, like I said before, your head and heart can be over here sad about love situations, but you have another situation over here where people are trying to capitalize off your sadness and your hurt. Sources said it doesn't have to happen to you first. You can listen to how people capitalize off people's pain. So yeah, I definitely see you taking a leap of faith forward. You have a lot of opportunities that lie ahead for you. And I see you saying you'd rather go it alone than be connected to, lower your standards. Here we have Ten of Pentacles. You and somebody who is coming together in your path, they're coming together in your path. They're also financially independent. They're hardworking just like you are. That's what you all have in common, is that you all are not waiting for other people to save you. You're not trying to wait for somebody to save you to capitalize off of someone else's pain and hurt and those kind of things. You're not trying to control someone's mind of you. You know, like, you're not trying to control people's minds, right? It's optional. They think what they want to think. You're cool with it, whatever. You're an air sign, so you're not trying to control other people's air. You know what I'm saying? And so you're okay if people are on your frequency, and you're okay if they're not on your frequency. You're not trying to control their air. Source will send the energies to you that connect with whatever frequency that you're on. So you're not trying to control that. Here we have the Knight of Pentacles here. So again, lets me know that you're a hardworking person, they're a hardworking person. This further confirms it, that they're a hardworking person. They're not looking for somebody to come save them financially. They're not a gold digger. You're not a gold digger. They got their coins. You got your coins and paper, whatever. So they got their stuff, they got their life, they have their values and stuff like that. It's really no sweat off your back. Even if the family values are different and you have to go your separate way, it's all good, right? But you do have some, so that's why Source is saying you're going to take the blindfolds off, because your ancestors are showing you, you'd rather detach from energies that like to, they all about just money. They don't care who they hurt, they don't care, you know, who they destroy, none of those things. They just don't care about that. So the blindfolds have been removed. Here we have the King of Cups. So here you are sitting on your throne carefully. You know, like I said, you're vetting your thoughts. You are, you know, pouring more into yourself, showing compassion towards yourself, but also being compassionate towards all energies involved, right? But also being fair-minded. Say, maybe, okay, you're not indecisive about things anymore. And that's what's going to upset a lot of people, that you learn how to save yourself and you're not looking for them to save you. That's what's going to upset a lot of people. Here we also have the Seven of Cups. So you're moving on in faith, right? You're moving forward in faith. Let's see what else we got going on here, Libras. Let's see what else we got going on here, right? Yeah, so I definitely feel like, you know, like I said, the energies that you want to align yourself with are people who are not, they don't have that gold digging energy. I'm going to get some money at all costs. I don't care who I destroy in the process. I'm going to get some money, right? Yeah. The reason why you want to take your blindfolds off too is because, and not only because your ancestors are saying take your blindfolds off, because they're trying to show you some things. That's why your anxiety is going to go away very soon. is that you also want to see the people that you're building a legacy with, and that they can see you, right? You're not walking around with just like, okay, I'm just waiting for somebody to just stick a quarter in my back. Speaking of spending, stick a quarter in my back and tell me which way to go. You all are incredibly smart sign. And I think, like I said before, it throws people off because you're ruled by Venus. And Venus is the planet of love, pleasure, art, music, aesthetics. You're ruled by a feminine planet. So the things that come to, things that you pray for, they come to you, right? Money comes to you. Love comes to you. People are attracted to you. They're also, the dark side of it is people who are green with envy, people who are vain and vengeful. So Source is saying to you, you attract everything because of your ruling planet, a feminine planet, right? So, like I said before, but you desire peace. Yeah, you desire peace, right? So that level of peace, that's a justice card, prudence, and also justice. Source is saying to you, you have to, in your fairness and in your equality, also have to tap into Source for wisdom. Source, Most High God. You're not getting wisdom from people who want to be idolized. You're getting wisdom directly from Source through prayer and meditation. So Source is cooking up something really nice for you as a result of you, you know, going to Source, you know, praying over it, praying for something. Here we also have the Three of Wands. You and somebody are taking a leap of faith, moving forward, and not a leap of fear. Like I said, whoever you and your person coming together, you know, you're going to feel free. That person could have brown hair. That person is very much in tune with just a positive attitude. They'll help you to keep your crown adjusted, you know. They're charismatic, you know. They're just free thinkers, you know, and how they think, right? They're not, like I said. And so here's a Temptations card, right? The Source is, like I said before, removing energies that when we see the devil card would be like enslaved to obsession, to lust, restrictions, right? So death and the devil card in tarot, those are all really the only two cards when they're in reverse, it's a good thing, right? But Source is saying to you, not really. It can be good or bad. It can be good or bad. Let me make sure because I know people are trying to learn about reading cards and stuff like that. It could be good or bad, either or. But I read the cards upright and in reverse. But in this case right here, Source is saying to you, there are people who are enslaved to the energy of money. So they never really have money because they don't think in circulation of wealth, right? They think in circulation of, I gotta hold on to money and I just want more of it. I want more. It's like a person who just has like, you know, nouveau rich. I gotta get more. Like a person who just hit the lottery. Oh my God, who can I hurt? And who can I sue? Who can I mess up their money? If I feel like they're getting closer and closer to money, who can I warm up to so I can get something from them? Who can I take a life insurance policy out on? Like, Source is saying the reason why you're getting away from those types of energies, because sometimes until it's done to your own kids, or sometimes until it's done to loved ones connected to you, until it's done to some energy, sometimes people don't, the rose colored glasses are sitting on your face until it's done directly. It's like sitting on your front porch. That's why Source is saying you are getting away from energies who are, imagine, since we're talking about these kids here, somebody has kids. Imagine when your kids get older and you work so hard to, you know, provide a life for your kids, and somebody coming along who, you know, wants to cut them down a size or cut their money or cut such and such. They don't want them to realize their dreams. They don't want them to. Yeah, so Source is saying, nah, you're not indecisive about things, right? Somebody may have even started drinking just because, or started going back to some things that you started doing. So it's just, replace that with faith, move forward, right? You're going through a rebirth right now. Somebody's definitely going through a rebirth right now. So going through a rebirth, you know, right now. So protect your energy, protect your energy, protect your energy, protect your energy. Yeah. this is a transition that you're going through in your life right now. You're going through a transition, you know, right now. And so you definitely want to protect yourself as you're going through this transition, and just recognize you want to look at, you know, reversed, right? Right. So, whenever you see the devil card and the hangman, they have more of a positive. That's what I was trying to say to you earlier, because I was looking at this. But anyway, that's whenever you see the hangman in the devil card, you know. So, like I said before, here we have the Three of Pentacles. Everything is lining up perfectly for you and everything. Like I see that you desire teamwork. I see that you desire communication, you know, that's important for you too. And some people won't communicate what their plans are because they like to keep you in a state of confusion. You would rather get along with people than fight with people, right? And some people would rather fight than get along, right? That doesn't align with you, no matter how long you've known them. And some of those people are right there in your own family, right? So, like I said before, the two cards, like I said, in tarot, I think I mentioned, did I say death and devil? But I meant to say hangman and devil. I was actually thinking about, when I was thinking about hangman, I was thinking about the book of Esther. But that's a whole nother situation. Anyway, so like I said before, you know, the devil card, like I said, came out. And it tells you right here, temptations, the tempter. But we know that Source created the tempter. So you got to recognize what your demons are first and foremost. If you're a person who the length of time, like if you got this family over everything, you may have to redefine family when the rose colored glasses have been removed. So you're not indecisive about how some people, for them, you thinking family over everything because you're moving from your heart chakra, and they thinking physical, like I said, money over everything, wealth over everything, material possessions over everything, practicality over everything, home over everything, health, generosity over everything, when you're trying to move from your heart chakra. So Source is saying, take the blindfolds off so you can see some things. So you can see some things here. Discipline. Right, so Source is saying hang in there with yourself, speaking of which, speaking of the hangman, oh shoot, when I just said the hangman, right, yeah, hangman, yeah, when I just said to you the hangman, right, so again, you know, when you see this, you're just learning how to hang in there with yourself. So if this card right here was in reverse, the waiting would be over. So somebody is still like, you're waiting on something having to do with the energy of money, and seeing how some people would place money, the value of money, just a paper and coins note over, you know, their heart chakra. So your head and heart are not at war with each other. So if you're, so yeah, some people will place money over anything. They'll sacrifice anything and anybody as far as money is concerned. And so Source is saying, but somebody was just not counting on your intellect. You know, your intellect. So you're not indecisive about it. Yep. What's the motive? Money. So some kind of new money is coming across your path. But at first it comes across, you know, you got new opportunities coming across your path. This is the Ace of Pentacles here. You got new opportunities coming across your path. Like very much of what you prayed for, you know, very much what you prayed for. So like I said, you're not indecisive. It's just unfortunate that people assume that you were not smart. And it's unfortunate that people assume that you are not smart, right? Because like I said, you got a new financial or career opportunity coming across your path. You've manifested this. You have abundance coming across your path. So again, you know, and it's, like I said, it's new. It's new. So you're not indecisive about it. So you're waiting on something, but it's something new coming across, as everything is lining up perfectly for you. Boom, 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 boom. So Source is saying, yeah. Here we have Dame of Pentacles again. So definitely feel like you, you know, like I said, dancing around the house, like as if no one's watching. You're just, you know, loving life. That's all I can say. It's like you're celebrating, you know. So like I said, some new abundance is coming into your life. Sources definitely aligning you with other hardworking people who are not trying to take advantage of people financially. You're leaving a circus behind. The full energy right here. You're embarking on this new cycle of life. You're embarking on a new endeavor. You're taking risks, right? Where other people have, still like to be engaged in foolishness and bad risk and all this other stuff. You're getting away from all of that, right? Yeah. You're getting away from all of that. Let's see what else we got going on here. The Hangman came out twice. Discipline card came out twice. So it's two types of energies in particular. Like I said before, you know, they just really succumb to their temptations, right? They've been overwhelmed, you know, by some things and by their temptations and things. And it's unfortunate. It's just when I look at this, I was trying to, yeah, it's unfortunate. But like I said, hang in there with yourself. Mercury is no longer retrograde. So, you know, things are speeding up. Sources need you to stay focused. Like really for real, stay focused, focused, focused. Here's the Strength card. Here's the Magician card. Here's the Temperance card, the Four of Pentacles. Yeah. Like I said, you left the circus situation behind. Some people are definitely, you know, operating in on a different frequency. They're operating on a totally different frequency. Yeah, they are tempted to go back because of the energy of money. They're going back into a circus situation. And so as a self-healer, this is you tapping into your strength and mastering spirit matters. You're dealing with energy who has an inability to control their passions. Whatever they're passionate about, they have an inability to control their passions. And you desire, here's a Temperance card, you desire conflict resolution, you desire harmony, and there's a imbalance in their spirit, right? And here we have Knight of Pentacles, right? So again, here you are, you know, working hard, you and your person coming together, working very hard. Like it's just really kind of two for two here. Yeah, it's kind of two for two here, looking at the cards. You've learned how to take your power back. This is the Magician card. You feel like somebody is under some kind of a trance or some kind of spell or something, right? And they're confused about things going on in their lives right now. They're disorganized in their mind. And so you initiated this change. You said, I'm leaving the circus. I'm not even waiting to see if they get their mind together. I'm leaving this circus. So like I said, you could have some situations going over here that you don't even think is connected to this, but all of it connects you to your universe, right? And so here we have the Four of Pentacles. You've learned how to be more conservative with your time, right? Because somebody was spending an enormous amount of time thinking about some stuff, but I see somebody planting some new seeds. So somebody could be relocating, right? At first, something could have been holding you up. Like, okay, I'm trying to see if people get their mind together. But hey, where you are right now, you're not waiting to see if people getting their mind together. You're just moving on. Let me see if I got anything else out here in your cards. Okay, another set of cards. Here are the questions for the moon, for this last quarter moon phase. Like I said, last quarter moon phase is about introspection. So when you see this video, this is when you like should be in introspection mode. Let's see what else we got going on. So let's see what else we got going on here so we can go ahead and close, get ready to close this out. Let's see what else we got going on here. Here are the questions for you. Here's the questions for you that's preparing you for this last quarter moon phase. So like I said, during your time of introspection, you can kind of sort of detach from the everyday what's going on and get back into becoming a better human being, investing in yourselves, maybe reading more books, maybe like I said before, keeping yourselves busy after leaving a circus situation and just moving forward. Yeah, I feel like somebody was going through a rite of passage and source needs you to keep on moving forward. Even if that's mean that you're going, doing it alone, you know, getting ready to prepare to meet your person, right? If that's your goal, person in business and or in love. Here we have the King of Wands. You have a lot of energies that are watching you, but everything is fine. Everything is fine. Here are the questions for you. First question is, what can you do to use your passion for serving on a large scale? Second question is, are you creating space for yourself to connect with your inner alchemist and innovator? Third question is, are you ready to think outside the box to delete old beliefs and rules to write your own? Fourth question, is using technology a drain or gain for you? And then last but not least is, are you ready to start a group in your community to initiate and create positive change on a local or global scale? And then what could the focus be? This is about being action oriented, right? Because when you're dealing with some energies who will do anything for money. And they like to keep people fired up. They like to watch people. They like to gang stalk, all of this other stuff, you know, to try to create some kind of fear. So fear cannot be your demon. Fear, doubt, uncertainty. So again, increase prayer life. Increase your prayer life. Here we have the Eight of Pentacles. And so it's two types of energies that spend an enormous amount of time, like I said before, you know, watching you. They watch everything that you do, right? So you'll be able to defend your decision not to go get reconnected with those energies without coming across as defensive. And part of it is, one, it's not your responsibility to carry other people's emotional burdens on your internal scales. That's one. And then another part of it is recognizing that you have the whole world in front of you. And that's what Source is trying to help somebody to see. It's like, you have so many opportunities to travel, to meet people, to connect with people, like physically, like connect with the earth and redefine the energy of money and redefine what family means and redefine. It's like so many opportunities. The whole world is open to you. So Source is saying to you, everything is fine. Everything is fine. Here we have the Four Pentacles. So you don't even have to spend a whole lot of time as it connects with two types of energies. And just, you know, like I said before, for them, if they see you as an asset to their lives and they have a goal to somehow, you know, connect with you and see what they can get from you and all of this other stuff, and you're a hardworking person, I'm looking at some energies that work harder to take money from people than to actually add to people's lives. I mean, in a nutshell, that's what I'm saying. People who work hard, they work harder on trying to take money from people than helping people to, you know, being a helpmate, right? As a friend in a business relationship or romantic situation. They put extra time in to try to take from people than to help people, right? So let me see what I'm looking at here. Yeah, so let's add all of this up here. Okay, let's add all of this up here. So first and foremost, you and your person are coming together. They're building their legacy. You're building, whether it's friendships or whatever, or romantic, relate. Maybe y'all going into business or whatever together. So let's look at this. We got knight. We got four and eight is 12. Plus three is 15. And then we got 16 here, right? So, hold on. Okay, we got four pentacles here, right? So, Source is saying to you, okay, we got eight and four is 12, right? Or let's not do that. Okay, so let's eight and three is 11, right? So they know technically your tens across the board, right? So we got 10 right here. Excuse me. 8 and 3 is 11 minus 1, obviously, is 10, right? So you got 10, 10, 10. So you're trying to be around other legacy builders, right? So that's 1. And then we have 5. We got 4 and 4 is 8. We got 9. So, yeah, financial independence is very, very important to you. And very hardworking energies are very important to you. Working not hard to take people's money away from them, but working hard to add to, you know, that, right? And so that can be taken a lot of different ways, though. It really can be taken a lot of different ways. 8, 9. So, yeah. So that's why I see you planting seeds somewhere else. I see somebody saying you're planting seeds somewhere else because, that's not something that I want to grow. I don't want to grow that kind of. And remember, leave some wiggle room for your own personal judgment, okay? This is where you're increasing your prayer life, because there are some people who will try to convince you that other people have tried to take money away from them and so on and so forth and try to disrupt your mind and, you know, such and such and such and such. But so you got to take things on case-by-case basis based on how you were treated directly, because some people have let me see how I can word this. Some people, their motive for keeping you connected to them and not broadening your horizons and your legacy is because, again, to try to control your way of thinking, trying to control how much time you invest in them, kind of trying to control your money and trying to control all aspects of that, right? So that's one thing, right? So keep your mind open, right? But that's what prayer is for. So you'll figure it out. Yeah, so like I was saying, we had to make them a little bit more room. That's what prayer is for. You'll figure it out because, again, some people will give you this false sense. Like, y'all know what I'm talking about. For example, it could be like your own family members, like because you are an asset to the family. So it gives this false sense of family because they're benefiting from your financial gain. So here you are moving from your heart chakra, head and heart being at war with each other, but yet and still something they're going to slip up and say, I'm talking about your family, something because we're starting out with family, right? They're going to slip up and say to let you know that, hey, they don't care what you have to sacrifice. Just give me a new this or pay this bill or take care of that or whatever the case may be. Rose colored glasses, like I said, are being removed. People have 24 hours in a day, just like you do. You want to align yourself with, you know, people who work just as hard as you do, and they're going up against all odds too. Maybe they're not, you know, aesthetically pleasing to a lot of people, but they're out here working hard. They just deliver from other people's opinions. Maybe people, they're the underdog, right? So a lot of rose colored glasses are being removed from a lot of people. So like I said, it's everybody. Rose colored glasses are being removed. So a lot of eye-opening situations here. So as you go through this cycle of just introspection, and also you can think of it this way too. Like if you are ever in some kind of a bind, you know, financially, and your head and heart are at war with people, could you go to them and ask them for help? You know, it's not all about money, but could you even go to them? When we're talking about the element of earth, and we're talking about money, wealth, material possessions, practicality, home, health, generosity, would they be generous with their time as far as you're concerned, right? It's not, we're not even just talking about just money. Would they be generous with their time without them getting something in return? Are they, you know, would they be able to cover a health expense if you end up, you know, like I said, stressed out and you couldn't work as hard as you were working before? Would they be able to help you in that regard? You know, do they have material possessions that is not a liability? It actually, the value increases where it's actually an asset. I mean, like somebody's learning the during this time, you're learning your own value, and you're actually adding tax and you're helping other people, but you're dealing with an incubus spirit. That's a male sex demon. It's time to start dating again. You are protected in love. Somebody never stopped loving you and they want to call you, but they haven't changed. It's time to open your vault. You inspired them to heal. So it's time for you to drink more water. It's a form of self-healing. You have the gift of premonition. That's forewarning, right? So tap into those gifts, right? If you're dealing with somebody who's dealing with a sex addiction and they'll do anything for money and they'll sleep with anybody for it, whatever the case may be, for you, you may, like I said, your heart and head may be at war with each other. It's like, man, you know, I'm trying to hang in there and trying to, there's nothing you can do for people who are overtaken by their demons, because in this case right here, if it involves money, they'll do anything for it, anything. And so, you're going to have to just send prayers to people, but keep it pushing, because one area of your life is absolutely impacting another area of your life. And so until you say, okay, I need to go ahead and release that. I need to go ahead and release that and get focused, because people are watching you and people are also watching them. 00. So you're closing out the cycles with two types of situations. Angels ask for your attention. Open your eyes and listen and think about everything that is happening, Libra. Trust your intuition and follow their guidance without any delay. Focus inward through meditation and prayer. Yeah. It's the waiting period where it just really sets you apart from people. In some people's waiting period, that's why Mercury is so, Mercury can be such a nightmare for some people when it goes retrograde, and it's no longer retrograde, by the way. When you watch this video, it won't be retrograde again. It can be a nightmare to people because people get tired of waiting on communication. But Source is saying to you to hang in there with yourself as it relates to two types of situations, because time is relative. And so I feel like you all have, you know, let people know, and you know, that you don't want to be confused anymore. You don't want to be burned out anymore. You're tired of the aggression that you've been on the receiving end of their aggression, excuse me. And so I definitely feel like you are, like I said, a lot of revelations coming out. And rose-colored glasses have been removed. Rose-colored glasses have been removed. So good for you, you know, for just hanging in there with yourselves and operating from agape love. Like I said, prayer for people. Prayer changes things for real. Like, people think it's just like, you know, oh, this person, they weak, they praying for people or whatever. But prayers and meditation answers, you know, get your answers. Here we have divine source is the idea that no person, place, or thing is your salvation, only love itself, right? And we're talking about agape love. We're not even talking about conditional love. Some people feel like other people, you know, just the love of money for them, the love of staying connected to energies that heighten their passion. They just like they can't control themselves, just overtaken by their demons. And so source is saying that you're going to have to move out of their way. You're going to have to let them move out of their way. You are going to have to move out of their way after now that you've seen some things. Keep it on the throne. Emotional intelligence. Letting go. Yep, somebody's going to have to let it go. I release what I can't control. I let go of doubt. I will not allow fear to stop me. I say goodbye to all that blocks my growth. I am weightless, free from burdens. I am shifting my perspective. I am free from regret. Failure is a helpful feedback, right? So you can look at it as failure. I was trying so hard. I thought I was going to give them everything that they needed, and that would stop them from, you know, their demons. Because that's why so much fire here. Source is saying it's not going to stop them. You cannot pay. You can't. Just like you can't. That's like paying for your salvation. Source already paid the cost for you, right? But so that flesh, those fleshly desires are real. Fleshly desires are real. We're not even just talking about sex. Tell a person, hey, you'll pay them to stop drinking, or you'll pay them to stop engaging in unhealthy sexual practices, or you'll pay them to stop, you know, stop eating, you know, unhealthy foods when the doctor just gave them a report that, hey, if they don't stop eating certain types of food, you paying somebody to do X, Y, and Z. Those demons are very real. But see, when the devil is busy, God is busier. So that's what I'm saying. You pray for people. You can pray for people, but get out of their way. Pray for people and get out of their way. Because you desire, that's what you've been going along with people for so long, that it causes you indecisiveness in other area of your life. So the energy is gaining momentum. So the closer and closer we get to the end of closing out this cycle, you need to be just that firm in closing out the cycle in love. Rose-colored glasses have been removed. So there's no ands, and ifs, or buts about it. So you don't want to end back up on the side of confusion. You stay moving forward, right? Because those energies, they are just that determined. Somebody's going to call you and ask you for some money. You know, I need some more money. Can you take care of this? Can you take care of that? You know, they burned out. They stressed out. They're in a form of confusion. I really need some help with this, that, and the other. And you're saying, I'm going to tell you just like I tell everybody else. I'm trying to inspire you to find the light within yourself. Get motivated. Get active. Take some kind of action. You've been trying to inspire people to a point of burnout. But hey, like I said before, somebody is trying to keep up with some Joneses. Whoever Joneses are, I don't know who they are, but somebody is trying to, somebody that you love possibly is trying to, you know, I don't know. They have this false sense of, you know, like I said, they are, you know, they have this pressure to keep up with social status, wealth, popularity, and you don't. So like I said before, I mean, get away from those types of energies. You're a Libra. It comes to you. You're ruled by a feminine planet. You're literally ruled by the planet, the goddess, the planet, goddess of love, pleasure, art, music, aesthetics, you know, peacemaker planet. And so it's your peaceful nature when you're sitting on your throne that attracts everything to you. It's your laughter, it's your intellect that attracts more money to you. So when you're, what, you got to get away from energies that feel like they got to create some kind of friction in order to, you know, like they like to stay in drama in order to make more money. So it's like you don't need to be around those types of energies. That's what I have for you. Because somebody has to find out, somebody may have had to find out the hard way. You know, those types of energies become green with envy and they like to disrupt your peace. They like to disrupt other people's peace. But again, prayer will expose all of that and who's what and put everything in perspective. I'll see you all in the next video. Bye.